Hello, this is James Hudnall, and I want to welcome you to another episode of Creative Secrets. This one is about conflict. Conflict is a major driving force in every story. If you don't have conflict, you probably don't have a story. It's one of the things that's required in a story, and I'll explain that in detail in a minute. But first, I want you to understand one thing. Conflict is not a fight. A fight is a byproduct of conflict, as I will soon discuss. As we discussed in a previous video, conflict is the thing that arises from the fact that the hero of the story wants something, and something stands in the way of them achieving their goal. Conflict is not action. Conflict is the reason action occurs. Conflict is the impetus that propels your story. Without a conflict, there is no motivation for the character. So you need conflict. Conflict is sort of like the glue that binds it all together. In the last episode, I talked about the meaning of a story and how important it is. Well, I left out conflict, but I probably shouldn't have. Conflict is one of the important things that gives meaning to a story. Without conflict, the emotional weight of a story can be lost. And so you need it completely. One of the important things you need to understand about conflict is that it gives the audience an insight into the character. The way that they respond to their particular situation is going to determine what kind of person they are in the eyes of the reader. And so you have to understand that the choices the character makes and how they deal with their conflict is enlightening about that character. Now, there are different types of conflict, and you have to choose the one that best serves your story. I'll break them down in a second, but first you have to understand something. You can have more than one type of conflict in your story. And when I get into story structure, I'll show you how you can do conflict for different sub-characters, but ultimately your main character is where the focus is going to be. So you are going to have to decide which type of character conflict you're going to deal with, as a primary and then secondary conflict. But don't let that intimidate you. We're just going to get into the concepts, and then you'll be able to figure out how to work them into your story. This is just a discussion that will make it clearer to you so you can understand the nature of it. Okay, number one is internal conflict. It's the conflict a character has with themselves, such as you can have moral dilemmas, you can have inner turmoil, you can have overcoming trauma. You can have psychological problems. There's different ways that you can have internal conflict, but it's all inside the character's head. It's their personal thing that they have to deal with, and how they deal with it is, again, enlightening to the type of character they are. It'll tell us a lot about them, and it'll give us a better insight into them, and it will help us to empathize with them more or not, which is, again, your choice. But you have to remember that. This kind of conflict works best in prose, such as books, such as comics, because it lets us get into the character's head, which is very hard to do on screen, but you can do it very effectively in print, which is, for example, how Stephen King has become so successful, because he knows how to do that particular thing very well. But the thing to remember about inner conflict is that a lot of times people are not honest with themselves. Sometimes they don't even see the facts about themselves inside themselves. And you as the writer's job is to help the character get to that realization so that they can learn something about themselves that they hadn't realized. And that revelation makes the story very powerful. And the course of the story, you will give them the opportunity to have what they call a character arc, where they start one way and then at the end they kind of become enlightened in some way or knowledgeable in another way at the end of the story. Interpersonal, number two, is about the conflict between people. So the people in your life, your friends, your family, people in your close circle, maybe your boss, but they're people that you interact with on a daily basis on some level. That is an interpersonal conflict. It does not deal necessarily with societal conflict, which is a larger scale issue. This is more about the things that are interpersonal, personal level. It has more of an impact on that level. So you need to focus on that understanding, and all the conflicts that arise from that are the conflicts that happen between people on that level. So for example, between a son and a mother, a daughter and a father, you know, that kind of conflict, or the conflict between a student and a teacher, or a boss and an employee. This kind of conflict is a very common conflict. This is where that level is. Number three, external. This is an easy one to explain. External is conflict is about the conflict between society or culture versus the main character. That stands in the way of the character's goals. So if a character, say, wanted to get married and they were gay in the 1960s, that would be a very insurmountable goal. Same thing with an interracial couple at that time, although people did get married back then that were interracial. But those are things that would be two examples of an external conflict. And an external conflict can involve all kinds of things, but it's essentially the forces that are larger than the interpersonal conflict. There are the forces of society or a government or something like that. That is what this particular conflict is about. And finally, we talk about the elemental conflict, which is larger than humans. It is elemental, as in the weather, as in the force of nature, beyond our control. And that is something that cannot be fought against, basically. It can only be dealt with in some way. Once again, your character's response to this is going to tell us a lot about your character. And so that's why you need to think about how they would respond. Now, they might have a learning curve, so in the beginning, they don't know how to deal with it, and in the end, they do, such as somebody lost in the woods, and then eventually they just develop skills to deal with things. But this is something that is going to be a combination of the internal and the external. But in the case of the external, it's the cosmic. It's beyond human beings. It's sort of like the human versus the inhuman. Therefore, it could be an animal that the hero is contending with, or the Terminators. The Terminator is sort of a example of this type of conflict, because it's not a human being. It's unpersonal. It's like a force of nature. So when you're dealing with that kind of a conflict, that's what this is called. So to summarize, a conflict is something that all stories arise from, and it determines the nature of your main character. It shows us what they're made of, what they're willing to do to get to their goal. So how your character acts and reacts to any given situation tells us a lot about them, and it makes us either like or dislike them, which I'll get into more when I deal with characterization. But this is the fundamental thing about conflict. It is a powerful force, and it is the fundamental force of your story. And that's why you need to focus on it whenever you're doing one. Okay, that wraps up this chapter, and I look forward to our discussion next time, where I'll be talking more about something called the premise and how that's important also. And if you will please look at the links below in the description to check out my new comic agenda, which is in its final run as a Indiegogo campaign. We're getting close to our goal, so you could help us out if you want to. Also, check out my books in the link below, and I just started a Patreon, so you can check that out too, and I appreciate it if you would help me out. See you next time. Thank you.